Xavier Arnaldo Rivera Hernández.
And José Julián Rivera Pérez. And today we are going to present our 2013 research project.
We are students from the University of Puerto Rico at Mayagüez, participating in the Student Research Opportunity Program at the University of Michigan, Ann Arbor. We are going to present the work that we have done in the Civil Engineering Department with Professors Dr. Ada Secos and Dr. Dimitris Secos.
One of the types of soil that has been found to be susceptible to liquefaction is gravel. Liquefaction occurs when water located at the pore are subjected to shear stress caused by an earthquake. Due that the water has no resistance in shear, the soil loses its effective stress and the structure fails.
Gravel is commonly found below critical structures, such as dams and levees. However, gravel behavior during seismic events is not well understood, primarily due to the need for special testing equipment.
A prototype large-scale cycle simple shear device has been developed at the University of Michigan that allows for the assessment of shear behavior of larger materials such as gravel. Three gravel materials were used, 6AA limestone, natural stone, and pea gravel. They were obtained from Stoneco Company, which operates a quarry in Ann Arbor, Michigan.
Now we are going to present a demonstration of the procedure to perform a test on the device. To perform a test using the cyclic shear device, we began stretching the membrane onto the bottom porous stone plate and locating the O-ring into the bottom ring groove. Locate the bottom shear ring lining up the two alignment holes with the corresponding marks on the base plate and insert the two pins into the alignment holes, stacking each ring one by one. After finalizing with the rings, stretch the membrane and tape it to the top rings.
Now, we are going to add the material. Before adding any amount of material, measure and record the weight that is being added to the specimen in batches. On this demonstration, we are going to use Ottawa sand as our specimen. To add it, pour the sand with a funnel, and the operator must keep the bottom part of the funnel near to the surface to prevent any compaction of the sand.
Once the specimen is prepared, slide the base plate back into the shear box and align the specimen horizontally so that it is centered underneath the loading mechanism, and then remove the alignment pins. Next, open the software located on the computer desktop and add the required information for the test on the project, specimen, consolidation, and shear table tab. After entering the data into the program, calibrate the machine using the system command of the program.
Once calibrated, the machine will reposition the top cap, lowering it until it reaches the surface of the specimen. When the green light on the machine flashes, the cap reaches the correct position, and it will now run the consolidation phase of the test by applying compression to the specimen until it reaches to the predefined normal stress.
When the test reaches the desired consolidation stress, remove all the tape that was holding the membrane. Next, secure the membrane to the top cap with the O-ring, and the machine will finish consolidation and automatically begin the shear phase. On this phase, the bottom platen is displaced horizontally to the left relative to the top platen as shown. This movement is the one that causes the shear strength of the specimen.
When the test is completed, a window will open saying that the test is finished and it will save the data. The data that was collected during this test will be analyzed to determine the shear resistance in the soil and with it, we can determine and model the behavior of gravel during liquefaction. We also want to express our gratitude to Dr. Ada Cercos and Dimitrios Cercos for offering us this opportunity for the summer. Also to the graduate student Jonathan Hobler for being our guide during all this summer.
Also, we want to thank the SROP program and their directors, Giselle Vélez and Mike Nazar, for the effort and dedication they put into this project. Thanks for watching us, and we are SROP 2013.